quarter on the weekend, midway through, Tom lunged for a spoil, competing against his opponent. He's sustained a high-grade injury to the proximal hamstring tendon. These sort of injuries will take between anywhere between 6 and 8 weeks to be fully rehabilitated. So unfortunately for Tom, that means that the season's over. So 3 weeks prior, Tom had sustained 2 heavy contusions to the hip. An MRI showed very high-grade contusions to the glute med muscle in the hip. Off the back of that, he reported some hamstring tightness, so we removed him from play. Now at that point, scans had showed there was no injury to the tendon whatsoever. Tom had returned to 2 weeks of normal training. He'd played the game against Melbourne the week prior without incident and had a fantastic week training on the track. This injury is a completely separate injury. It is to the tendon proper, and unfortunately it's a high grade one. Tom Lynch was competing against Brody Grundy in a contest midway through the second quarter. During that incident, he felt a sharp pain in the hamstring. Scans have shown that that's a low grade muscle injury, and it's likely to take 2 to 3 weeks to see Tom return to play. The surgeon has cleared Rory to play against the Bulldogs. He's been training well for a few weeks now, so we're really looking forward to seeing how his training progresses this week and hopefully seeing him out there on the weekend. Will's progressing really well. He's got no clinical signs of concussion at the moment. The docs are monitoring him daily, and the task now is to slowly progress his training loads in the gym and on the field and make sure that there's no recurrence or return of symptoms. So the docs are working through that progress at the moment. I think at the moment we'll be waiting to see what his progress is like over the next 7 to 10 days. So he's looking good at the moment, but we're yet to test his response to exercise. So we'll monitor that closely and see. Brad had been training really well and then slipped on a wet veranda. He felt some symptoms around the proximal hamstring tendon just under the buttock in response to the slip. Scans were very reassuring, showing no major issue in the area other than what had previously existed. 2 days later, Brad was already running at 3/4 pace and showed really good strength in the region. So while this might delay his return for a week or so, we're pretty happy with where he sits at the moment. Wayne's been showing nice progress. We just need to be careful over the next couple of weeks to make sure we don't increase the training loads too quickly. So we'll be watching him closely this week and hoping to see him back in 2 to 3.